students, next we will see a topic under functional dependency, that is a minimal cover of a functional dependency. We will see the concept with an example. The question will be like this: find the minimal cover of a set of functional dependencies given. So you will be given a set of functional dependencies and we have to find the minimal cover of a set of functional dependencies. So this is a set of dependencies given: A to BC, B to C, and AB to D. First of all, we will see the definition of minimal cover. A minimal cover of a set of FD, F is a minimal set of functional dependencies F min that is equivalent to F. There can be many such minimal covers for a set of functional dependencies F. So from the definition, we can understand minimal cover will be defined for a set of functional dependencies and it is a set of dependencies which is equivalent to F. So we can define many such set which are equivalent to F. So if the question is given like this, you have to find one of the equivalent set of F, that will be its minimal cover. So we will see the steps to find minimal cover. First step is the right hand side of all functional dependencies should be a single attribute. Second step, remove the extraneous attribute. Third step, eliminate redundant functional dependencies. So we will apply these steps to the given set of dependencies. So the first step is we have to ensure whether the right hand side of all dependencies contains a single attribute. So this is a set given. If you see the first dependency from A to BC, here BC is the right hand side, so right hand side contains two attribute. So in the first step we have to eliminate this two attribute or convert this two attribute into single attributes. So from A to BC a dependency exists, so we can write it as A to B and A to C by applying decomposition rule. Decomposition rule is an Armstrong's axiom we have studied in the previous session. So according to decomposition rule, a dependency from A to BC can be rewritten as A to B and A to C. So the set of dependencies F is rewritten as F1 equal to A to B, A to C. Then next dependency B to C, right hand side has only a single attribute. Then next one AB to D, here also right side has a single attribute. So that's all about the result of first step. Now the second step is remove extraneous attribute. So we will see what is an extraneous attribute. Extraneous attribute is a redundant attribute or additional attribute on the left side of functional dependency. So here extraneous attribute is an additional attribute which may appear in the left side of a dependency. So extraneous attribute definitely will appear in the left side only. So if you see the set F1, first dependency is from A to B, here only one attribute in the left side, so there will not be any additional attribute. Then A to C, B to C are similar, only single attribute is there in the left side, so there will not be additional attribute. Now the last dependency is from AB to D. So here either A or B will be an extraneous attribute or additional attribute that should be eliminated in the second step or in this step. So we have to find whether A or B is an extraneous attribute. First we are checking whether A is an extraneous attribute or not. So to find whether A is an extraneous attribute, we have to find the attribute closure of the remaining attribute, that is B. So attribute closure is a concept we studied in the previous session, that is a set of attributes which are related to B that we have to find out. Here attribute closure of B is represented as B plus, that is equal to, we have obtained a set BC. That is, there will be always exist a dependency from B to B. So B can be included in the closure. Then B to C is a dependency which is given in the set. So C is related to B. So C also will be included in closure of B. So B's closure will be set BC. Here we can see, after finding out the closure of B, B is not related to D. So within this dependency AB to D, B is not actually related to D. So definitely A must be related to D. Then only we can define a functional dependency like this. So A is not an extraneous attribute here, or A cannot be removed in this step. If A is removed, this dependency cannot be further defined. So A is not an extraneous attribute. So definitely B will be an extraneous attribute, that we will check. Now to check whether B is an extraneous attribute, we will find the closure of the remaining attribute, that is A. Closure of A is denoted as A plus equal to A to A always exist, so A will be included. A to B is given in the question, so B is related to A, B is included. A to C is given in the question, C is included. Then finally, D is also included in the closure of A. That is because in the previous step, we have seen B is not related to D, and there exists a dependency from AB to D also. So definitely A will be dependent to D, or D will be dependent on A. So we can define a dependency from A to D, or D can be included in the closure of A. So from this step, it's clear that in order to define a functional dependency from AB to D or A to D, B is not necessary. Actually, D is related to A only. So here, since D is included in the closure of A, B can be considered as an extraneous attribute. So we have to eliminate the extraneous attribute in this step. So the set will be rewritten as F to A to B, A to C, B to C. AB to D is rewritten as A to D. We have eliminated B from the dependency since it's an extraneous attribute. Now the third step is eliminate redundant functional dependency. Here redundant functional dependency means additional functional dependencies which may not be required. We can see this set F2, A to B exist, then B to C exist. Then if A to B and B to C exist, A to C can be derived from this by applying transitivity rule. Transitivity rule is again an Armstrong's axiom we have studied in the previous session. So if A to B and B to C exist, A to C can be inferred or derived from it. So we don't have to include it in the set F2. So the dependency A to C can be considered as an additional or redundant or unwanted functional dependency that can be eliminated in the third step. So here after step 3, we will get a set of dependencies F3, A to B, B to C, A to C is removed, and finally A to D. So this is a set of minimal cover of F. So this is how minimal cover of a set of functional dependency is to be derived. So in the first step, we have considered the right hand side of the dependencies. In the right hand side, a single attribute must be there. If there are more than one attributes in the right side, we can decompose it. In the second step, we have removed the extraneous attributes. So extraneous attributes always comes in the left side. So if we have more than one attribute in the left side of a dependency, only one will be required, other attribute will be extraneous attribute, that will be eliminated. And in the third step, elimination of additional functional dependencies. Finally, you will get a set of dependencies that will be the minimal cover of the given set F. So that's all about the concept of minimal cover of functional dependency. Now these are some tutorial questions on functional dependency. You try these questions. First question is, we have studied the concept, given a relation with functional dependencies are given, you have to find the D plus, that is attribute closure of D and attribute closure of EF. Second question is, let E is this set of functional dependencies, find the minimal cover that we have studied now. Then third question, write an algorithm to compute attribute closure of a set of attributes under the set of functional dependencies in F. So all these questions are previous university questions. This algorithm is given in the textbook. You refer the textbook and find the algorithm. It's given in the Silberschatz textbook. Find any three uses of attribute closure algorithm. Next question, determine any two candidate keys of a relation with this given of functional dependencies. So how to find a candidate key from this? Candidate key means that will be, there will exist a dependency from every attribute to candidate key. Candidate key must be unique for a relation. So when candidate key is repeated, all the attributes will be repeated. So from this set of functional dependencies given, by applying Armstrong's axioms, you have to find what are the attributes to which all the attributes are functionally depended on. That will be considered as a candidate key. The next question, given the functional dependency so and so, write the sequence of Armstrong's axiom needed to arrive a dependency from P to T, PR to S, QR to SU. So we have to apply Armstrong's axiom to get these dependencies. You have to show the different steps. Next question is, compute the closure of a set of functional dependency F for a relation schema with given functional dependencies. Again, you have to find closure by applying Armstrong's axioms. Consider a set R in this having below mentioned functional dependencies, find the closure of FT. That is also by applying Armstrong's axioms. So all of you, try these questions and submit it as soon as possible. Date will be announced later. Thank you.